The Cab Vice President Lenny Robredo denounces rumors of an alleged sex video involving her eldest daughter. Robredo spokesperson Barry Gutierrez calls the allegations a malicious fabrication and a crime. He says they're studying options for legal actions. They have also asked concerned online platforms to remove the post targeting Aika Robredo. Human rights lawyer Chel Diokno uploaded a screenshot of the post containing links to the supposed sex video. Diokno is running for senator under the vice president, accused political rivals of peddling the allegations. He said it takes a special kind of evil to resort to such misogynistic attacks.
Here's our Monday brief on the campaign trail. House Deputy Speaker Lito Atienza says he is no longer backing out from the vice presidential race. That's after presidential bet Senator Panfilo Lacson rejected his call for both of them to abandon their candidacies and instead form a tandem of their running mates, Senator Manny Pacquiao and Senate President Vicente Soto III. Lacson presented a counteroffer Saturday for Soto to become his and Pacquiao's common VP bet. But Atienza claims the suggestion may just strengthen the campaign of survey frontrunner Bongbong Marcos. Meanwhile, Lacson reveals it was former Quezon City Mayor Jun Simon who asked him to drop out of the presidential race to give way to a tandem of Soto and Vice President Lenny Robredo.
It will not happen. Kung sasabihin na mag-withdraw ako, I will not withdraw. No, hindi naman ako ganun eh. Kasi when I put my heart into a crusade to advance my advocacies, that's it.
Robredo's camp says Simon is not authorized to speak for their campaign and that his actions were his own personal initiative. Meanwhile, Pacquiao took his campaign to Zamboanga del Norte. He shrugged off his poor survey numbers and said he is counting on the support of overseas Filipinos to boost his bid. The Commission on Elections denying allegations of pre-shaded ballots in some precincts for overseas voting. In separate Facebook posts, voters from Singapore and Dubai claimed they received pre-shaded ballots at the embassy and were only handed new ones when they complained. The Philippine Embassy in Singapore refuted this, but it admitted there was one incident wherein a spoiled ballot from Sunday's voting exercise was inadvertently and unintentionally given to a voter. It maintains it was an isolated incident and that it was recorded in the minutes of voting. The COMELEC vows to look into the matter.
Kapag halimbawa, sabihin na natin totoo na may pre-shading, dapat nakita yun ng watcher. Number one. Number two, meron kasi tinatawag na minutes of voting. Ang tanong ko, yung bang pre-shaded na balota at yung incident na yun, na-report ba yun sa minutes of voting? Kasi kung walang na-report sa minutes of voting, at wala rin nakita yung watcher, wala rin na-object yung watcher, isa lang ibig sabihin, ito yung sinasabi niya.
Vice Presidential candidate Sara Duterte Carpio expressing grave concern about reports of pre-shaded ballots in voting precincts abroad, especially since those reports claim it was her name that was pre-shaded in the ballots, along with some senatorial candidates. Duterte Carpio reiterates she does not condone, nor will she ever condone, cheating. The Davao Mayor's camp also calls on COMELEC to investigate the issue.
Officials now exempted from the COMELEC's gun ban. They include the vice president, members of Congress, Supreme Court justices, cabinet secretaries, and state prosecutors. Also granted exemption, officials of the National Bureau of Investigation and election officers. The officials, however, need to submit to the poll body a list of their firearms and qualified security detail. They're also allowed to carry just one firearm.
Which officials we believe need to feel secure in performing their duties free from fear and pressure from others. I do not want any senior government official to get injured or lose his life from an armed assailant simply because he cannot defend himself with his own firearm due to the gun ban.